Show.
For years, the Mr. Men and Little Misses have sailed upon the sea, exploring the world. Being out on the open ocean can make one feel quite alone. Or in Mr. Bump's case, quite wet. Of course, to some, the sea means catching fish. And whatever else may be lurking in the deep waters.
Here you go, Mr. Crumpy! The best deep sea fishing spot in the whole ocean!
Well, it had better be, Miss Scary, because we want to land a tuna as big as this one. Don't we, Mr. Quiet?
Yeah, I'd be happy if I caught a jellyfish.
Oh, that's nothing!
Ha! You're calling 300 pounds of fighting fish nothing?
Mr. Grumpy, what would you say if I told you we were going to catch a sea monster?
I'd say you were a loony bird. This brochure promises tuna, and that's what we intend to catch.
There's nothing scary about tuna.
You clearly don't know your tuna.
Give us a go. How hard can it be?
What do you think you're doing?
I'm throwing fish guts in the water to attract the sea monsters.
Miss Scary, keep your little sea monster dreams for another trip. We're going after tuna.
I'm telling you, there's a sea monster out there.
She's right. Sea monster by the stern.
And I'm telling you, there's nothing in that sea but fish.
Plus a big sea monster.
Fish that are waiting to be caught. And I'm just the man to do it, especially with my new fly, guaranteed to attract a 300-pound tuna.
You think that's big? A sea monster weighs 1,000 pounds. Good thing I bought a big net.
Whoop, I've got a nibble.
Uh-oh, does it feel like the grip of a sea monster jaws?
No, it feels like a tuna put up a fight.
Sea monster's back over here.
Let me help.
Get your own fish. This baby's mine.
Mr. Quiet, help! I can't hold him!
I am perfectly capable of pulling in my own tuna. Thank you very much, Miss Scary. Got it!
Oh, you were right! That's no sea monster! It's barely a tuna!
Well, I'm just getting warmed up. That's how it works in fishing, which you'd know if you weren't so crazy about your sea monster.
I tried to tell you.
It's a sea monster! Fantastic! Oh, reel him in, Mr. Grumpy! Reel him in!
Oh, crooked cucumbers! I told you not to use those fish guts, Miss Scary!
Over here! Come and get us!
Go, Miss Quiet, go!
Wait! I want a picture with it!
That's my favourite hat!
Sometimes it takes a team of explorers to find something lost deep in the sea, particularly if that something happens to be Mr. Stubborn's ship.
Oh, Pickles.
Whoa! Fast launch! Everyone all right back there?
Oh, wonderful, Miss Daredevil!
You're on, Mr. Happy.
Testing. 1, 2, 3. Mr. Happy here, coming to you live from under the sea, where we're searching for the good ship Stubborn, which sank a year ago today. Here to help us locate exactly where it sank is the captain of that ship, Mr. Stubborn. There is no story to report because my ship did not sink.
Oh, but it did, Mr. Stubborn. Also with Mr. Stubborn is his first mate from that unfortunate voyage, Miss Chatterbox.
I'm on live TV. That makes me nervous. I don't know why. I watch TV all the time at home, but being on, it's totally different.
I do not know why I even agreed to come on this undersea voyage.
I think we're getting close to the spot where your ship sank, Mr. Stubborn.
You are a poor excuse for a captain, Miss Daredevil. My ship is not down here.
We've hit something. It's a sunken ship.
Viewers, we seem to have hit a ship. Could it be the good ship, Stubborn?
It is not the good ship, Stubborn, because my ship did not sink. You are wasting your time watching this TV report.
We found it. I can see the name on the side.
For the last time, my ship did not sink. This submarine is cheap.
Uh-oh, looks like we've sprung a leak, which could be a problem given that we're underwater and everything.
Shut up and let's get out of here.
Whoa, this is turning out to be quite an adventure. If you've just tuned in, we found the good ship Stubborn, but I'm afraid we have to abandon the submarine.
You are all a bunch of worry guts. It's just a little water. This submarine is not sinking.
Tune in next time when we search for Miss Daredevil's sunken submarine, which is probably next to Mr. Stubborn's sunken ship.
You! Ahoy there! Everyone okay? Where's Mr. Stubborn?
I do not know why you had to eject us, Miss Daredevil.
Don't worry, Mr. Stubborn, I've got you.
That submarine was not sinking, and my ship did not sink. Oh, this life jacket is...
Way out in the middle of the Dillydale Sea is a tiny island where a group of shipwrecked Mr. Men are waiting to be rescued.
Still no sign of life, Mr. Nosy.
Not a thing, Mr. Small. Maybe we could glue our broken boat back together and sail it home.
All the glue in all the world couldn't put the good ship Humpty back together again, Nose. But take heart, someone is sure to see the help sign that Mr. Lazy is spelling out with coconuts. Oh, we're doomed.
Let me see these. You are probably using them all wrong.
Oh, I don't think so, Mr. Root. I'm very good with binoculars, also spyglasses and listening devices.
Oh, tell it to someone who cares. We're saved! Over here, you nincompoops!
Look, Miss Whoops! Those island people are waving at us! Everyone is so friendly in these parts.
Those aren't island people, Miss Helpful. They're the missing castaways.
Goodness, you're right. They might be hungry or sick. Best be prepared.
I'd better paddle faster.
Whoops.
Ooh, they're coming towards us.
How much room is on that rowboat?
I see 4 seats.
Only 4? I'll go lead them into shore.
Hello there, Mr. Root. Well, we're certainly glad to find you.
Oh, spare the chit-chat. Let's go. The others will just weigh us down.
Oh, there's room for everyone, especially when I get rid of this food.
Are you crazy? I have been eating nothing but coconut for 30 days.
Just trying to be helpful.
Oh, never mind. When I get home, I can eat all the beans I want.
Whoops. Don't worry. I've still got a paddle. Let me give you poor people a hug.
Me too.
If you think I am giving up this seat, think again. Are you people coming or what? Oh, never mind. I'll row myself home. There is no paddle in this boat. I am drifting away, you nincompoops. What kind of rescue boat doesn't have a paddle?
I've got your paddle right here, Mr. Root.
But I am going to float away.
Don't worry. We'll be here waiting just in case you drift back in.
Why is the world so full of buffoons?
Another day of being out to sea comes to a close for the Mr. Men and Little Misses.
Oh!
Won't be long before they're back out on the water. There's no doubt that everyone in Dillydale loves the sea. Well, almost everyone.